Okay, everyone, so I'm going to give you some tips when it comes to wiring your own mini split. If you're a DIY person, you want to, this wire here is the one that's going to go to the inside connected to the indoor unit. And sometimes, just so you can double check your wiring connections and make sure you're doing it right, because your manual might be in Spanish, and actually that's the case in this unit, for example, or you might have lost a manual, or you just want to double check and make sure you did it the right way. So most of these units are labeled 1, 2, the middle one would be 3, 4, and 5. The middle one is going to be your ground wire, and of course this connection here has 5 wires. So if you look real close here, right there, you see there's a number 1, and there's a number 2 with an N on it. And then the number 3 is going to be your ground. That should be green in color. And then this one has a number 3 on it. It's just on the other side of this wire, a number 4. And then look closely here. This one has a number 5 on it, which matches these numbers up here. So your ground wire, sometimes they have a way or a means to connect it. This one doesn't. I'm trying to feel down here and you don't. I don't feel it. So what I did is I just connected it to this screw here. And you can see the wire back here. It does have a number 3 on it. It's just tucked in there and you can't see it. But another way is you can kind of match the colors. Most of the times there will be the same color. So brown, and you see brown here. And this blue, you see a blue wire there. And then you just make sure that your numbers match the numbers that are here. And in some cases, not all, the wires here would also match the same colors of wire here. This one, this model in particular, does not do it. But just a little wiring tip I wanted to hand out to everyone that's planning to do your own DIY mini split installation. This will help you make sure that you don't zap or fry your unit.